Welcome back, viewers, and today we've got an interesting question that we're going to be talking about that has to do with, hey, your ancestor was a polygamist. How does that impact your DNA results? Now, for many people, they may be thinking that, oh, this is an easy question to answer. It's just a matter of, it's like, you know, endogamy or pedigree collapse where you have lots of people. And that is not correct. This is not the same thing as endogamy or pedigree collapse. So that's the first thing to remember. The second thing then is to remember is, what does this entail? So polygamy is basically having multiple spouses. Now, that could be the same thing as if you had somebody who their spouse died and they remarried and had more children. And so you have successive marriages, or maybe they divorced and married somebody else and had more children there. So you could have somebody that actually has successive marriages for that. And of course, if you just ignore marriage completely, there's some people who just have lots of partners and maybe have children with multiple partners. So all of these are really in the same category as far as how they're going to affect your DNA. And you'll notice that none of them are endogamy or pedigree collapse. If we have multiple spouses and then we have lots of children because of that, that's really going to equate to a higher probability of having a large family. Now, in particular, most of the time when we're talking about polygamy or successive marriages or lots of partners, we're really focused on the men. Because when you think about it, if a man has three wives, all three of those wives could be pregnant at the same time. They could be having kids pretty close to one another. However, if a woman had three husbands, she can only be pregnant by one of them at a time. And so it's going to be, you know, 9 months till that child's born. And there's going to be a time period before she can be pregnant again with that same person or somebody else's child. So really here we're talking about men having really large families with multiple women. So what does this mean? Well, if you have a really large family, it's actually a really good thing for DNA, because it is a much higher likelihood of having more DNA matches. Well, let's go and take a look at an example so that we can see what I'm talking about. Now, in my family tree, I have a ancestor, Lyndsay Anderson Brady, and he was a polygamist. He was part of the Mormon pioneers that came to Utah, and he had at least three wives here. If we scroll down, we can see that he had his first wife married in 1831, and they had 10 kids. And then his second wife married in 1852 while he was still married to his first wife. And you can see that because of when some of the kids were being raised there. And then his third wife he married in 1863. And again, had some more kids with his third wife. So in total, there's 5, 4, 9, plus 10, 19 children just with those three wives. And I think some people have told me that there is actually some more wives, but I haven't done much research on him, so I don't know for certain. If we go and look at ThruLines, this is a great tool, because what we can see is for each one of these people, hey, there's four DNA matches. There's four DNA matches. One DNA match, one DNA match. I can scroll down to my fourth great grandparents. So here is my fourth great grandparents, and Lyndsay Anderson Brady is one of them. And we can just start to hover over each one of these to see, hey, how many matches are they, to get a rough idea. So I've got 9, 8, 11, 8, 8, 10, 9, 9, none, 22, 22, 26, you know, 19, 22, 36, 44, ooh, 97. And actually, this is one of the daughters of Lyndsay Anderson Brady. And here we see Lyndsay Anderson Brady. He has 413. Now, we've seen some 30s and 40s, and Keziah had up to 97. Lindsay's wife Elizabeth Ann, I have 392 for. Now remember, she was one that had 10 kids, so she already had a large family as it is. And then there was two other wives of Lyndsay that had another 9 kids total. But as I look at some of these others, I'm back down, okay, 50, 60, 27, 70, 48. Nothing in this fourth great grandparents that is anywhere close to what Lyndsay Anderson Brady has. In fact, if you add up all of the fourth great grandparent matches, except for Lyndsay and Elizabeth, they have more combined, those two combined, than all of the rest of my fourth great grandparents. Which is something interesting because you have a lot of fourth great grandparents. So 413 matches. Let's go in and actually look at how these are distributed. All right, so taking a look at through lines, you can see here through Tranquilla Ann, I have 57 matches. Through Lyndsay Brady, I have 20 matches, which is the son of Lyndsay Brady. Jordan, I got 70. Keziah, I got 69. Elizabeth, I got 26. Warren, I got 83. Marion, I got 44. And then through Daniel here, I have 1. Now, if you'll notice, Daniel is a half third great grand uncle. So he would be from one of the other wives of Lyndsay Brady. And if I scroll back to the other side, I can see even more. And there's some more from these half that have just 1, as well as some that have 8 and 7. So overall, with Lyndsay Brady, I have 13 of his children identified that I have matches through. So getting to 413 matches means I've got lots of possibilities to be able to trace these through. Now, from a practical standpoint then, when I'm looking at match lists, because Lyndsay and his wife, Elizabeth, are the majority of the fourth great grandparents, actually the majority of my matches all follow through Lyndsay Brady. So for instance, when I've made a leads chart sometimes, I have a good portion of them, more than half, that are through this one line. In fact, I think it's almost 80% of all of my matches are through this one line, simply because they had more children in this family than anybody else. And then there was multiple wives that also had children as well. Now, there's one other thing that you should be aware of, and that is a higher probability of having pedigree collapse. And it depends on how far back in time this line is. But with these larger families, that means there's more kids and better chance that those kids might have children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren that end up marrying each other, and so your pedigree tree collapses in on itself. Let me show you how that is starting to happen here. If I go back to Family Search to this family, we can see that Lyndsay Anderson Brady shows up right here. There's Elizabeth Ann Hendrickson and Keziah Francis Brady. But that wasn't the one that I had showed you that I was related through, because that is over here. Lyndsay Anderson Brady with Elizabeth Ann Hendrickson. So the same couple, their daughter Tranquilla. Now Tranquilla was about 5 years younger than Keziah, and Keziah had a child when she was 20. And then that child, Cynthia, she had a child when she was 17. Whereas Tranquilla had a child when she was 35, and that person married, those two people married. So in other words, Sophia is the first cousin once removed of Silas. Tranquilla's daughter married Keziah's grandson. From this line, basically everything back from Lyndsay and Elizabeth is the same thing as it is over here. So I don't branch out from those two. Those two are basically connected together. Because they had this large family, they could have children that had children and grandchildren that are actually closer in age because of when they were being born. So be aware of that as you're looking at it. If you have these large families or families that have multiple marriages within it, That doesn't mean that there's going to be pedigree collapse, but there's a higher probability of that happening. And so be looking for that in your family tree. Now, if you'd like to learn something more about DNA, watch this video right up above. But if you want to learn something else, then check out this video down below.